Hi. Ready for some intergenerational quickfire questions? Here we go. What is your name?
My name is Preety Bhandari.
My name is Amara Nwuneli.
And where are you from?
I am from India.
I am from Lagos, Nigeria, from the state of Anambra.
What title do you have, or how would you describe yourself?
I'm currently working as a senior advisor on climate and finance at the World Resources Institute.
I am the founder of Fight Global Warming Nigeria, which essentially raises awareness about climate change among youth.
What was your first climate or environmental conference?
You're really taking me down the history lane over here. My first climate conference was 1989. That was my first job right out of college after graduation. This think tank, the Energy and Resources Institute, perhaps organized the first conference in a developing country on this issue of global warming, and that was my first exposure to this issue. And 30 years or odd down the line, I'm still working on the issue, so that should tell you the longevity of the issue and where we are in terms of how the discourse has evolved over time.
This is actually my first climate conference, and I have done conferences before, but they were more national around Nigeria. So I'm so excited to be exposed to the international crowd of youth activists and also activists, because it's very inspiring.
How old were you when you first heard about climate change?
I was all of 24 years old.
I was exposed to climate change when I was around 9-8 years old, which when I experienced it firsthand when my house got flooded and I saw how detrimental the effects were.
What area of climate solutions do you feel is most urgent?
I don't think we have the luxury of time to look at it piecemeal in terms of issues, or we are in it all together for all issues. But to the extent we can reorient it from the perspective of, people who are going to be impacted, people who do not have the wherewithal to cope, I think that is the orientation we need in this process now.
Well, especially in Lagos, Nigeria, I feel like urban development and green spaces is the most urgent, because not only does it give us solutions, but it fixes all the problems of overpopulation and air pollution and land pollution and just the food and agriculture sector. And I feel like once we devote all our time into making sure that we plan our communities well, all of our lives will be improved to a certain point where we can start focusing on the smaller, minor details.
Who was your first climate hero?
My first climate hero was my first boss, R.K. Pachauri. He was also the chair of the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. He had the foresight as a think tank to see that this is going to be an issue that that countries, especially developing countries like India, need to be involved in right from the beginning.
I'm going to be a little bit corny and say my first climate hero was my mom, because agriculture is what Nigeria depends on for food and for livelihood. And I know that climate change affects that heavily. So every morning I would wake up to her talking about how climate change is affecting one of another farm and how life is so hard for farmers. And so I know that she works every single day to better the life of farmers and then better the life of the food of people who don't have access to food. And so my first climate champion was my mother.
What responsibility do you feel that your generation has to secure a safe future?
At my age, I think my biggest responsibility is to provide whatever knowledge, whatever I can share with the younger generation, because I think the answer lies there. It is not an abdication of responsibility of my generation, but it is our responsibility to capacitate the next one to ensure that solutions are found and found now rather than when it becomes too late to save it all.
Sadly, we were born into climate change, and the older generations don't think that there's a solution out of it, no matter how much they talk. So we have to take the responsibility of not only fighting, but succeeding against climate change. We have to brave all the disastrous effects, all the hurricanes and floods and droughts, and how our livelihoods are changed because of it. And the one thing that I want to say that we have to take on is the right and to never be afraid to speak up to people older than us, to speak up to larger corporations, and to speak our mind and share our stories.
That's great. Thanks so much.
Thank you.